And Kuz Sampola. Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online yoga workshop, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR, Nehru Wangchuk Cultural Center. Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My sincere prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties in the whole Bhutan. Coming to the today's workout, today's practice also depend on the sun salutations, and after that Pavana Mukta Asanas, really anti-rheumatic group part 2. It's a very simple and effective warm-ups. Anyone can easily adopt this kind of today's schedules also towards your self yoga exercises. And now coming to the practices, coming to the first sun salutations, open your both the arms and lift your both the arms up. And then slowly bring your pranamasana at your chest level and take care of your awareness and also take care of your convenience while doing these practices. And if possible, throughout the practices, try to maintain your prideful mood. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasya Vihitam Mukham Tattvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Drustaye. Om Hram Hrim Hrum Haim Haum Raha Mitra Ravi Surya Bhanu Kagapushna Hiranya Garbhamaricha Aditya Savitra Arka Bhaskaraya Namaha. Stretch your arms forward, lift your arms, Hasta Uttanasana, and once completely pull up and slight or medium back bend, Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Again, keep your back straight. When you have issues with the forward bends, when you have health issues with the forward bends, avoid especially the forward bends even in your regular activities. So remaining people, slowly, carefully bend the body forward till the floor or touch the palms towards the floor, or accordingly bend the body, but press your head towards the knees and stay. And after that, right leg must be your back leg, called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. Push your body down as well as forward. Try to press your one part of abdomen with the front folded leg thigh. Lift your chin further up. Then here, without lifting your back up, and keep your back leg straight on the toes, back leg knee up against the gravity. Then slowly forward leg towards the back leg, called Dandasana or Santulanasana. Then here, completely bend the body down towards the floor, called Ashtanga Namaskarasana or Sastanga Namaskarasana. Few seconds stay here in this relaxation posture. Then after that, push your body forward, lift the body completely up like a sea wave, called lifted head cobra or Bhujangasana. And another, we have another posture, we have semi inverted posture as well as semi forward bend, called mountain posture or Parvatasana. And push your body inside and right leg again forward leg, called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding stance. And back leg straight on the toes and back leg knee up, join your back leg to the forward leg, called Padahastasana. Few seconds stay. Then here, lift your both the arms at a time up along with the body, lift the arms, and once completely pull up and slight or medium back bend at the Chakrasana or at the Chandrasana. Again, keep your back straight. And here, pranamasana above to the head, and slowly bring your pranamasana towards your chest, called Anahata Pranamasana. And take one long inhalation, exhalation. After that, with inhalation, lift your both the arms up, and with exhalation, wide your both the hands. Then slowly turn your palms and bring them back towards the thighs. Then soon after that, wide your legs and lock your hands back, and long, slow, fast inhalations and exhalations. So in our today's exercise, Pavana Mukta Asana Sreni or anti-rheumatic group, so we have group 2 postures now. Last time we did some of the exercises related to the same group. So today we have the same warm-up practices, especially for the hands and the wrist and the fingers. And also we have good exercises for the neck. So let us start with the neck exercises first. Right, keep your back straight and try to sit in any convenient, comfortable posture on any convenient surface. So take a long inhalation, exhalation. So before coming to we have to start actually Mustika Bandhana or Mani Bandhana Naman. So we that is actually for the arms. But today's exercise will start from the neck and head, and after that we'll come to the hands. Alright, now coming to the isometric exercises for the head. So every day morning after getting up or as well as before your bedding time, you can choose this kind of simple exercises to encounter for the neck rigidness. Just press your head and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then right, come back. Then here same hand frame must put together behind the head, but press your head forward and stay here for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, relaxation comes straight. But when you have severe dizziness or giddiness, don't follow the next exercise, but you can choose proper way, simple way of doing. Lift your chin up and add your hand frame on the forehead. Press your head more back and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, relaxations enough. Keep your head straight. Then slowly leave your arms here. Once take a long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. And in this isometric exercises, our next pattern, side presses, and keep your right hand or left hand and concerned head part to press it. So here apply that opposite side equal force and then very slowly get back to normal. Then opposite side, same thing, keep your palm or the concerned head part and press and stay. 1, 2, 3, and 4, relaxations enough. Then slowly come back to normal. And after taking one long inhalation, exhalation, turn your head towards your right side with your same right arm support. Press your head from exact side angle and stay. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then slowly get back to normal. And opposite side, same thing, turn the head and press your head and stay. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then again here also once relax your head. So take again long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation, keep your head straight, interlock your fingers from the forehead, from forward, and few seconds press and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then slowly keep your hands down, again take a long, slow inhalation and exhalation. So finally keep your both the palms joined under the chin and try to make a frame and try to lift your chin up. At the same time, try to press your chin also down, and 2, 1, and then 0, then slowly get back to normal, then take a long slow inhalation and exhalation. And soon after that, once lift your shoulders till your neck point to lift the shoulders up till the neck point and slowly get back. Second count till the neck point, lift the shoulders and slowly get back. Last count, lift the shoulder till the neck point and then come straight. After relaxation, your neck point. Now coming to the next exercises, lift your chin up with inhalation. And with exhalation, keep your chin straight. Or if you have no neck issues or no particular like throwing issues in the inside the head, keep your chin completely down towards the throat. Again, slowly inhalation, lift your chin up, stretch your chin, stretch your throat. And exhalation completely down. Again, inhalation, lift your head completely up. And exhalation, then very slowly come back to normal. Or press your chin towards the throat. Then straight your head. So one inhalation, exhalation towards your right side. Towards your right side, bend your heads. 1. Then very slowly come back. So in this Griva Sanchara, now towards opposite side, neck bending. Bend your head more. And slowly come back. Your right side, bend your heads. 1. And slowly come back. Your left side, bend your heads. 2. Then very slowly get back to normal. Take again long, slow inhalation, exhalation. This time towards your right side. Towards your right side, turn the heads. 1. And then very slowly come straight. Opposite side, turn your heads. 2. And again straight. Your right side, turn your heads. 1. And then straight. Your left side, turn your heads. 2. Then very slowly come back. So here one long deep inhalation, exhalation. And for the next exercise, very important exercise for the people who are repeatedly giving catching that issue called neck rigidness. So lift your chin up, keep your spine straight, lift your chin up, towards your right side and towards your left side only half cycles, chin up half cycle, just move your head in a half rotating way towards the shoulders, right shoulder once and come back, left shoulder once, come back, right shoulder once, come back, and left shoulder once, and then slowly come back. So when you have no neck issues or like especially cervical region issues, so in that particular case, just choose next rotation, inhalations, lift your chin and heads, and exhalation completely downs. Again, inhalation, lift your heads, and exhalation completely downs. So last count, inhalations, lift your chin and heads, and exhalation completely downs. Then same thing, opposite side, inhalation, lift your chin and heads, and exhalation completely down. Second count, inhalation, lift your head and chin, and exhalation completely down. So last count, breathe in, lift your head and chin, and breathe out and slowly get back to normal. Then here, keep your head straight with your two arms with closed fist or with open hands. Just try to give a proper rubbing on the neck area and neck region. Then strides. Keep your arms straight. So one, stretch your legs for relaxation. Take a long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. So you can choose this kind of simple warm-up exercises every day before your yoga practices, before your physical workouts. Right. Keep your back straight again. Try to sit comfortably in any convenient posture. Coming to simple exercise, hand cleansing or Mustika Bandhan. So open your two hands forward. Then completely close your fist with breathe out. Then very slowly breathe in, wide the hand. So try to completely put your mind at the posture and practice, and slowly fold your fist. Then slowly wide your palms. So last count, close the fist and few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then very slowly get back to normal. Completely wide and stay. 1, 2, and 3, relaxation. Keep your hands down. Again, just take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. So coming to wrist bending, very simple exercise, Mani Bandhana Naman. Open your both the arms, then close your fist. Now completely keep your fist down, then slowly keep your fist up, and keep your completely fist down and fist up. So here, when you want coordinate your breath, exhalation, keep your fist down, and breathe in, lift your fist up. So last count, completely keep your fist down and stay at that stretching point. Observe your forearm stretching. 1, 2, and 3. Completely lift your fist up and stay. 1, 2, 3. Then very slowly come back to normal. Same exercise you can choose with open fingers also. Then free your palms and just move your fingers completely downwards and completely upwards. Completely downwards and completely upwards, and slowly come back. Take again long, slow and deep inhalation, exhalation. Alright, coming to next level exercise, Mani Bandha Chakra or Mani Bandhana Chakra. Very simple exercise and effective exercise, especially for the people like who are senior citizens. For them, it's also a very simple way of workouts. So lift your both the arms, close your fist. Then here, wrist joint rotation, just movement. Exhalation down the wrist and inhalation, lift the fist. Exhalation down and inhalation up. Exhalation down and inhalation up. Opposite side, same thing. Breathe out down, breathe in up. Again, breathe out down, breathe in up. Last count, breathe out down and breathe in up. Then very slowly open the palm and slowly keep your palms down. Just long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So next exercise will be Kehuni Naman or elbow bending. This is also very simple exercise. So here, open your right hand. Now turn the palm. Just fold your elbow with breathe out. Then slowly come back, breathe in. Again, breathe out, fold the hand. And breathe in wide. So last count, breathe out, fold. Then very slowly, breathe in wide. Then slowly turn the palm and down. Opposite side, same thing, open your both the hand. Then turn the palm, breathe out, fold your palm, and breathe in, open. Second count, breathe out, fold. and breathe in open. So last count, breathe out, fold and breathe in open. Then come back. Take a long pause. So next exercise will be Kehuni Chakra or elbow rotation. Also very simple and effective practice, especially for the people who are having shoulder issues. For them, it's a good remedy. Open your both the palms and turn the palms towards the sky and fold your hands. Then wide your elbow, completely wide stretch. Then from there, bring your elbows down. From there, lift your elbows up with inhalation. And with exhalation, bring your elbows down. With inhalation, lift your elbows up. Last count, elbows down with breathe out. And breathe in, lift your elbows completely up and slowly get back. Opposite side, same thing, lift your elbows. And exhalation, completely down. Second count, inhalation, lift the elbows. And exhalation down. So here it is also a kind of exercises for skandha or shoulder wall also. Then slowly come back and last count, lifts and then exhalation, then comes straight. Then slowly keep your hands on. Especially for the skandha chakra or shoulder socket rotation is a different rotation. We can include the same exercise while in the elbow turn, or we can do a separate exercise for the shoulders. First lift your shoulders and slowly get back to normal, and these kinds of rotation, lift and then slowly get back. Third, last count, inhalation, lift your shoulders and exhalation down. Opposite side, same thing, lift your shoulders and exhalation down. Second count, inhalation, lifts and exhalation down. Third, last count, inhalation and exhalation that down. Take again long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. So here, one quick relaxation. So after that, we will see similar exercises in Pavana Mukta Asana Srini, the same anti-rheumatic group. Some of the variations which are very useful for, especially for the sports people as well as for even for all. Okay, coming to the practices. Again, try to comfortably sit in any convenient, comfortable posture. Alright, open your left hand forward, keep your all the fingers down. Use alternate arm support to turn your fingers more to add more stretching at the elbow region, at the palm region and stay. Then after that, same hand palm lift up and try to push your hand forward without bending your elbow. Turn the fingers completely back. Then turn the palm completely out but facing the fingers towards the floor. After that, with the alternate arm support from below, completely press and stay now. One, and try to put your arm while turning your fingers, reverse turn on the knee or on the floor to have the great stretch on the forearm region. Then slowly get back to normal. After that, fold your hand, then wide your elbow completely outside and against your head, few seconds stay now. Then finally keep your same elbow point straight. After that, hold your same elbow with your opposite side hand, press it inside and stay. One and two relaxations, enough. Then slowly open your arm and take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. And opposite side, same thing, open your alternate arm forward, all the fingers completely point down with alternate palm support. Press your palm inside and stay. One, two and three, come back. And lift your palm up, point your fingers abovewards. With alternate arm support, completely press your palm back and stay. One, two, and three relaxations, enough. So here, turn the palm completely outside, but point your fingers down towards the floor from belowwards. Completely press your palm inside and try to place them on the on the floor or on the knee to have that good stretch on the forearm. And then finally, lift the palm and fold your hand. Wide your elbow, turn the head opposite side. Few seconds, stay. Then after that, keep your elbow straight. Then hold your elbow with alternate arm support to press it inside to have your good contraction at the shoulder level. Then slowly get back to normal. Take again long, slow inhalation, exhalation. Right, this time open your left hand forward. Keep your all the fingers straight. After that, use your right arm to catch your that open hand with your opposite side, like lever, turn the palm and stay for a while and observe that shoulder stretch as well as it's a lattice muscle stretch here. And 3, 2 and 1, then slowly get back to normal. And here opposite side, same thing, open your arm and with your alternate arm support, catch them properly, completely rotate and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then very slowly get back to Undamal. Again, here also, once as an interlude, you can add this Skanda Chakra or shoulder ball rotations, and 2 and 1, then clockwise and anti-clockwise, and 0, relaxations. Again, take a long, slow inhalation, exhalation. So this time, lift your left hand up and fold it behind the head. Use your alternate arm support to maximum give a stretch on the shoulder level and the elbow level, and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then stretch your both the hands. And fold alternate arm, give a maximum press and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 6. Now again, lift your both the arms and slowly give your relaxation to the arms, and take a long, slow inhalation and exhalation. So in these variations, in the same anti-rheumatic group, group 2, in the same variation, we have elbow locks and lock your 2 elbows. So here you can stay here, or you can lift your 2 elbows up, or still further maintain a back bend here and stay. 1, 2, and 3, relaxations enough, then slowly get back to normal. So in fact, this kind of variation will give extra relaxation or extra stretches and extra flexibility to the body. It will be so beneficial to do remaining other postures. And opposite side elbow wrap your 2 elbows and keep a lock. Lift your 2 elbows up and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then relaxations enough, then slowly get back to normal. Again, few seconds relaxations. So in the same flow, we have alternate elbow rotation. So one hand above fold and one hand opposite side below fold. Try to lock your elbows behind the body and stay now. 1, 2, 3, and 4, relaxations enough, then slowly get back. So 1, relaxation, take a long deep inhalation, exhalation, then after that again relift the hands, then start choosing the same kind of bending opposite side, then try to have your back lock, or at least try to put your fingers together and have that stretch or squeeze in between your both the shoulders. 2, 1, and 0, relaxation, sit up, then very slowly keep your both the arms wide, then slowly take care of your relaxation. Again, long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalations. Then here, open your left hand forward, catch your right knee, or catch your alternate leg, opposite side toes. Now try to keep lift your remaining hand up towards your below shoulder side. Just make a bend and stay. 1, 2, and 3, relaxations enough, come straight. Then very slowly turn your hand and slowly catch your opposite side knee with your first hand. Lift your alternate arm up just to have your complete bend and stay. 1, 2, 3, and 4, relaxations enough, then slowly get back to normal. Again, long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. So we have spinal cord turning also. So simple twisting exercise. Keep your both the arms as supporters, one hand on the knee, one hand back of the body on the fist or on the palm. Keep lift your above back and turn the above back and head towards back side and stay. 1, 2, and 3, relaxations enough, then slowly get back to normal. And opposite side, same thing. Choose proper way of holding the knee and back arm properly. Set it as a pillar to turn the body and stay. 1, 2, 3, and 4, relaxations enough. Again, long, slow, and a deep inhalation, exhalation. So in fact, in this same row, we have many other variations. So whenever we have a good time to do all these exercises, we will demonstrate. Now let's coming to the pranayam practices. Before pranayam, once relax your legs by keeping them folding legs to the right side, left side movement, or butterfly movement, or any convenient pre-position. After your relaxation, again get back to normal to the practices of the pranayam. It's also advised to give at least 5 minutes between your yoga physical practices and yoga pranayam, and in that meantime you can prepare your mind and body, and also you can have a small amount of water. Also drinking water also advisable to for the people who are interested in chanting of mantras. All right, now choose proper way of doing so. Choose a simple effective postures to be in the posture to perform this pranayam. You can choose any convenient surface, lotus posture or half lotus, or any other meditative posture like can be chosen. Keep your back straight and prepare your mind and body. And coming to mantra sadhan and sloka, so today also we have very simple exercise. One is called Bhastrika Pranayam, the second one is Eka Nasa Swasa, single nostril breath. So coming to the practices of sloka and mantra chanting. Om Kesavaya Swaha, Om Madhavaya Swaha, Om Narayanaya Swaha, Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Siddhyadham Asana Purvakan Pranayama Dhin Karishe Om Sandh Sandh Sandhi. Alright, keep your hands down and take a long deep inhalation exhalation. So in other words, it is saying that the total practices of yoga or pranayam or all styles of the yoga, purpose of the yoga is the same, called to make us fit from the physical level and mental level and social level and further spiritual level. So yoga is a simple form, simple tool to make us like health and fit from the inner side and also from the physical level, mental and social and spiritual. And coming to the exercises, this exercises belongs to Bhastrika. Bhastrika is saying that Vata Pitta Slashma Haram Sari Ragni Vivardhanam Kundali Bodhakam Kshupram Pavanam Sukadam Hitam Brahma Nadi Mukhe Samasta Kapadhyargala Anasanam. So this is only one good pranayam, which is take care about our internal phlegm related issues, internal bile related issues, as well as internal wind related issues. And also it is saying a Sarir Agni Vivardhana means metabolic activator or immunity activator, and also it is a good practice to create some heat inside. And this is good exercises to create good health to the lungs and the total wind system inside, including wind pipes and including the minute air catching parts in the lungs called alveoli. And this is also good exercise to make us alert, just before your pranayam or just before your yoga practices, just before your puja or rituals or meditations. So it is one of the easiest and good practices to make you alert. And next exercise is called Eka Nasa Swasa, single nostril breath. So one is Ida Swasa and one is Pingala Swasa. So in a row of activity, we will see that practice also. So let us start with the first Bhastrika Pranayam. Bhastrika Pranayam contraindications are, please remember, when you have severe ear problems or any other related head organs disturbances, please do not immediately jump into these practices. And also when you have severe nasal issues or throat issues or any other complications, don't immediately choose this activity. Bhastrika is a bellows breathing. So at a time, sharp inhalation will immediately fill your lungs, and after that, slow exhalation will vacate the lungs. Alright, keep your back straight and take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. Right, starting our exercise, sharp inhalation, slow exhalation. In a row of activity, we are doing 30 strokes at a time. Then starting our exercise, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, then one quick relaxation. Take long, slow inhalation, exhalation. So as we mentioned before, we have single nostril breathing with us called Ida Swasa or Pingala Swasa. So in the for our two nostrils, we have different names in Sanskrit called for left nostril it is called as Ida, for right nostril it is called as Pingala. So here we are doing Ida Swasa first. Ida Swasa means single nostril. First close your right nostril with your right thumb and keep on functioning with the left nostril. Only inhalation, exhalation with the left nostril. And same left nostril breathe out. Again, completely slow inhalation with the left. And breathe out. So last inhalation. And completely slowly last exhalations. Alright, keep your hand down, take a long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. So after your regular inhalation, exhalation, we are doing same exercises with the right nostril. Pingala Swasa, so your right hand last two fingers should close your left nostril, or according to your convenience, close your left nostril and inhale with your right. And exhalation with the right. Again, inhalation with the right. Exhalation with the right. Last inhalation with the right. And completely slowly breathe out with the right. Alright. Now try to keep your arm out and few seconds break. Basically this single nostril breathe out also improve your breath pattern and also it will clear the nasal passages. Alright, so in the last we have mudra called Varuna Mudra. Varuna Mudra are the gesture of the water. So basically it will improve the or it will check the errors inside the body which is related to the water element. And also it will give better results in making our skin healthy and glow. And also it will act as like a somewhat it will encounter to the some of the skin issues called dryness or itching on the skin and dryness in the eyes and ears and dryness in the mouth. Very simple and effective remedy for the people who are having this kind of dryness issues. So just open your both the hands, after that fold your little finger inside and just press the tip of the finger with the thumb and few seconds have your awareness and devotion at the same mudra and few seconds stay alert in this practice. Slowly come back. So whenever you have free time in your offices or in your homes, you can choose this kind of simple mudras also, because it will not demand a special dress or special equipment. Just you can fold your fingers and you can enjoy your practices. Alright, so after finishing your yoga activity, yoga practices, depend on your strength level, depend on the intensity level, it is also advised to give some more time to give relaxation to the body and mind in the form of yoga nidra or power nap. And also after your total workout, like 50 minutes time to half an hour time may require to take bath and further 10 minutes time to take breakfast. These timings totally depend on the individual capabilities and individual style of practices. And in the afternoon, before your lunch time, try to see all the possibilities how to take a power nap or how to do a yoga nidra to regenerate your body and mind. It will improve your focus levels and concentration levels. Basically, it will improve the productivity from you. And in the evening, once you will be totally free from your activities and efforts, before your dinner time, try to take at least half an hour time to do yoga activity. So in that yoga activity, try to see this important lineup called back bending exercises and leg stretchings and inversion postures, strength training technique, then in the ending short sleep. So this is what we call BLISS, back bending exercises and leg stretchings, inversion postures, and coming to strength training, and also coming to short sleep method. And you can choose proper way of breathing and breathe outs also in this same pattern. And we are meeting here at the same place with the same content on Wednesday. So we will see still more good exercises on Wednesday. Wednesday we have chair yoga. Until then, take care of yourself and stay away from the bad habits and do yoga also. Thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity.